Hello and welcome back. The Honda City has been the go-to sedan in the C2 segment, and in its latest 5th generation Avatar, it has got better than ever. But like before, it comes with a CVT, which performs brilliantly in the urban environment. But what happens when it comes to outright performance in a hilly area? Well, that's what we're here to find out today, and I have come to a hilly road to test the CVT of the latest Honda City. Not just that, we'll even do a couple of extension runs to find out how it is in flat out performance. But before I proceed, do subscribe to us and give us a thumbs up if you like our work. To start with the basic specifications, the latest Honda City comes with a 1.5-liter petrol engine like before, but then as per Honda, this is a completely new engine that benefits from DOHC and a 16-valve setup. Talking about the performance figures, well, you get a peak output of 121 PS and a maximum torque of 145 Nm. The motor comes mated to a 7-step CVT, and you also get pedal shifters to up the fun quotient. Like I said, driving the City CVT in an urban environment is quite a breeze, as you're offered with sufficiently braced performance and a lot of smoothness. However, when you come to a hilly road like this, especially on the steep inclines, there is this pronounced rubber band effect. Well, things never go out of hand, but yeah, there are instances when the rise in speed is not proportionate to the increase in the engine RPM. Also, as the engine RPM increases substantially when you compare it with the speed, even the NVH levels take a hit due to the increase in the sound level from the engine. However, things get a lot better after 2000 RPM, and there's a progressive build-up of momentum until the red line. That said, things really get a bit bothersome when you have to slow down to almost a halt and then pick speed again on a steep incline. Now, yet another way to overcome these issues is to shift to S mode, wherein the car does feel a lot more energetic. Now, another problem is, as the car is being pushed harder in the S mode, it's sure to have a detrimental effect on the overall fuel efficiency. And also, the engine, as we said, gets a bit too vocal when being pushed hard. And while I might be nitpicking here, finally, there's one more area in which CVTs in general are not as good as a conventional transmission, and that's with the downshifting. Although there's still some retardation when you downshift and do that for engine braking, it's definitely not as pronounced as it is in a conventional automatic transmission. So when going downhill, if you're thinking of using downshifting as a means to slow down your car, well, these CVTs, they are just not designed for this practice. So guys, that was about the City CVT on a hilly road. And now we have come to a straight closed road where we'll be putting this car through its paces, doing a few acceleration runs and finding out how this car performs in flat out driving. Not just that, to have an idea of the exact performance, we'll be comparing the acceleration timings of this vehicle with its manual counterpart. So let me slot into the S mode and start accelerating really hard. So guys, this brings us to the end of our video, and as you just saw, the Honda City CVT might not be the best choice on a hilly road. Sure, it gets the job done, it takes you to your destination on a hilly road, but maybe there are a few areas in which it could have been better. Even in outright acceleration, it's not as fast as its manual counterpart, but then again, it's not too slow either. So does that mean the City should have had a torque converter automatic instead? Well, not really, because if you're someone who's gonna use this car mostly in a metropolitan city, well, it will be up for all sorts of driving from all sorts of drivers. Not just that, as a sedan for someone who loves seated driving or for someone who wants to enjoy the comfort of a back seat, the City CVT makes a lot of sense. Sure, its CVT is not as good as a DCT or a well-tuned torque converter automatic transmission, but overall, the latest Honda City CVT comes across as a well-sorted, no-nonsense package. So this is all we have for you today. Once again, I request you to subscribe to us and do hit the thumbs up if you like our work. It's me, your host Yatharth Chauhan, signing off for now. We'll meet soon on 91 Wheels YouTube channel.